हाय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू बीए थर्ड इंग्लिश ड्रामा क्लास। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी हैव सीन द सिलेबस इन डिटेल एंड पैटर्न ऑफ क्वेश्चन पेपर। Today we are going to see different types of drama. The objectives of this unit is to discuss in detail the kinds of drama that we see being performed to read. Plays are categorized and labeled as tragedy, comedy, history, problem plays, poetic drama, epic drama, the theater of the absurd, etc. The present unit explains as to how these distinctions are made, what reasons behind the specific labels are, and what time period socially and politically has been responsible for their growth. The unit has a subdivision on Indian classical Sanskrit theatre, which discusses the Indian aesthetic theory. One would do well not to ignore in Sanskrit drama, as it has been a landmark development in the growth of theatre at the world level. This also initiates the growth of drama as a part of new literature, which is inclusive of Spanish, German, French, Indian dramatic writing, etc. Actually, Sanskrit drama is not included in the syllabus prescribed by Shivaji University Kolhapur for the students of BA Part 3rd. Though Sanskrit is our own language used in Vedic period, ancient India, people used to speak with each other in Sanskrit language. But nowadays you know very well that Sanskrit is no more a language of communication. So the language of communication is English. Now worldwide, if you want to communicate worldwide, English is a main language to communicate with the people around the world. Though our language is Marathi, mother tongue, we must know the national language Hindi and international language that is English. English drama is no doubt a pioneer in the field of literature by William Shakespeare. But before him, there were many dramatists tried their level best in the field of drama. Greek tragedy or Spanish tragedy, we know very well. So different types of drama have existed down the ages from Greek classical theater to the present times. Since the Greek age, Greek empire, or Greek culture, drama rapidly and consistently developed. We have already read about the origin and growth of drama in our first unit. Before learning this unit, different types of drama, we have seen in the semester 5 the origin and development of the drama with special reference of Greek drama and British drama. There may be some questions in your mind while discussing the drama and its different types. We will definitely try to answer all these questions and we will try to understand different kinds of drama: entertaining, realistic, romantic, relation-based, and theme-oriented. So such kinds of drama are available. There are many dramatists in India also who contributed in a very large, in a very vast manner, and in a very large number in the field of English drama. Though the history of English drama is rich, Indian dramatists also contributed some part of their intentions or their skill in this field also. There are many types of drama, like tragedy you know very well. Comedy is one kind of a drama. Tragicomedy is another type. Then there are history plays. There are problem plays. There are realistic drama. There are poetic drama. There are epic theaters also. Theater of absurd. So these are the types of dramas. We are going to see briefly the information of these types of drama, and we will try to understand what is the tragedy, what is the comedy, what is the tragicomedy, history plays, problem plays, realistic plays, etc. Today we are going to see the tragedy as a type of drama. You know very well that Aristotle first defined tragedy in his Poetics. Poetics is his book. Around 330 BC, he defined tragedy as the imitation of an action that is serious and also having magnitude complete in itself, in the medium of poetic language and in the manner of dramatic rather than of narrative presentation. So you might have remembered the definition of tragedy made by Aristotle, involving incidents arousing pity and fear, wherewith to accomplish the catharsis of such emotions. So tragedy brings you or the spectators towards the pity and fear at the end of the drama. So if you want to understand the tragedy, you must know how it works, how the fall of the hero occurs. Aristotle says that the tragic hero will evoke pity and fear at the end of the drama. If he is neither thoroughly good nor thoroughly bad, but a mixture of both, but is certainly better than we are in the sense that he is of higher than ordinary moral youth. The spectators who generally see the drama thinks that hero is more than common people, supernatural, and hero cannot do any kind of a mistake. The spectator thinks, but the situation is different in tragedy. Such a man is exhibited as suffering a change in future or fortune from happiness to misery because his mistaken choice of an action to which he is led by his hemorrhagia. The tragic flaw or the error of judgment or a moral weakness is his character. The plot evokes tragic pity and fear. In this way, tragedy reveals the spectators of harmful emotion. The dramatist depicts incidents which arouse pity and fear for the protagonist, bringing the plot to the logical and possible conclusion. You might have known about four great tragedies of William Shakespeare, that is King Lear, Macbeth, Hamlet, and I think Othello. These are the four great tragedies, and if you see all these great tragedies, he created or he managed a plot in such a way that the downfall of that hero definitely occurs at the end of the play. And that's why there creates a pity and fear in the minds of the spectators. So this is the condition of the tragedy, that pity and fear should be emerged in the minds of spectators or the audience. Thus, catharsis in spectators gives a satisfaction despite it being a tragic play. In his tragedies, Shakespeare is indeed grappling with the whole world on a scale approximated only by the profound tragedies of Greece. Tragedy in his work goes beyond individual failure. Nations crumble in ambition, lust, and ingratitude sear the earth. Sensitive soul shudder. The question, the chimeras of man and fate receiving dusty answers. There are many such kinds of tragedies. Spanish tragedy by Thomas Kidd, you might have known about on the tragedy. But unless and until there are pity and fear or the hemorrhagia or the catharsis in the tragedy will not be a tragedy. You must understand this. Hamlet and Lear are partially authors of their own suffering because of their conduct. Hamlet and King Lear, they are responsible for their deeds, and that's why their downfall occurs. In Othello, also, there is a downfall of Othello due to his own behavior or his own mentality because of his jealousy towards Iago and others. And that's why Othello's downfall occurs in that tragedy. So, tragedy is definitely an important part of or the type of drama. We must understand this. Thank you very much.